Hello everyone, welcome to Pediatric Dermatology by Dr. Anand. Today's topic of choice is this wonderful dermatological condition for which I would like to thank Dr. Anurag Vaid, one of my pediatric dermatology friend from Jammu. So he had shared this picture so that we can share the knowledge with the rest of the whole world. So a two and a half year old child came with complaints of mosquito bite and the lesions on the face. A 2.5-year-old child came with complaints of mosquito bites, okay, and these small lesions on the face. And there's one more picture also I'll show you after some time. And this the thought process is that this mosquito bites and the lesion on the face, they are only on the exposed part. These rashes, the lesion, they are only on the exposed part and they are not on the non-exposed part. Okay, so what do you think? What comes to your mind? So yes, very important. Today we're going to talk about papular urticaria. Papular urticaria, P-A-P-U-L-A-R, papular urticaria. What is papular urticaria? It is a common chronic condition of recurrent papules. You can see, right? Papules, see, macule is change in color and papule is change in color plus elevation, right? So it's a common chronic condition of recurrent papules because of the hypersensitivity to the arthropod bites, okay, like a flea bite. The most commonest cause is the flea bites. Are you understanding? That is why I told you there is a history of mosquito bite and all that. How these lesions will present? They'll be erythematous, they'll be urticarial pruritic papules, okay, papules, very important, okay. And what else should we know in general regarding this case? So excoriation and even secondary bacterial superinfection is common in these conditions. Also, these lesions, they usually heal with post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. That also you should know. Okay, what else do you want to know? So you can see a papule. You can see around the periphery of the papule, you can see a halo. Okay, and in the center of the papule, you can see a hemorrhagic punctum. Okay, hemorrhagic punctum, you can see, which are in these papules could be grouped also. We could not have a derma lens. That is why we couldn't show you in detail the hemorrhagic punctum. And it is on the exposed part that you should know. These were the important points, you know. And how about the differential diagnosis? See, this urticaria, this papular urticaria could be, they have multiple differentials. Like just urticaria, it could be bullous impetigo, it could be this lymphomatoid papulosis. Okay, so why it is not just a urticaria? Why I am stressing on papular urticaria only? Why I am not saying it is just a urticaria, just a mosquito bite? So most importantly, if it is just a urticaria, in the urticaria, you know, this puncta, which I have told you, hemorrhagic punctum, you know, these things will be absent in urticaria. Urticaria will be transient, right? With individual lesions and which resolves over few hours, right? And also, you know, in papular urticaria, you will see, I told you just now, puncta, even crusting vesicles, bulla also can be seen in papular urticaria. But in just urticaria, a plain urticaria, this puncta, crusting vesicles, bulla will be absent. It will be transient. It will resolve in few hours, like that. That you should know. And there are multiple differential diagnoses of papular urticaria, but at least one or two you should know. Bullous impetigo, just urticaria, bullous pemphigoid, lymphomatoid papulosis and all those things. Okay, how do you want to diagnose this? It is a clinical diagnosis. You look at the patient and you know you can reveal this adhematous pruritic papules with little plaques with central puncta and hair crusting also sometimes you see. Okay, what will you see in skin biopsy? Like rarely it is done, but if you do, you will reveal the dermal and epidermal edema, okay, with numerous eosinophils. That's what you see in skin biopsy of the papular urticaria. How do you want to treat it? It's very easy, sir. You can give oral antihistamines, could be cold compresses, could be any topical antipruritic cream like calamine lotion, camphor lotion, menthol lotions, like that. If it is a very severe problem, symptomatic lesions are there, then what do you want to give? So you want to give topical corticosteroids ointments for younger children, like mild strength preparation comes that you give, you know. And most importantly, you know, exposure time to go for playing, you know, you be little careful in that. Avoid any high risk activities, use protective clothing, use insect repellents, like that. These are the conditions. That was all about important things regarding papular urticaria. I hope you liked the video. I would like to thank Dr. Anurag Vaid. Because of him, we are able to make this video. And for more such amazing updates, you can, you know, join our free WhatsApp group on 9999897081. And thank you so much for watching. Have a good day.